So maybe for beginning, let's get a little bit acquainted. Azure here represents of publishers. Yes, thank you. And developers, I know, also developer. Okay. Any other spheres? Yes, then I know you. And you, what kind of sphere do you represent? From what? App Annie. Ah, okay. It's just why I'm asking, because I think that this this speech will be mostly useful for publishers and developers, but all people can find something useful out of it for them. So let's begin. The title of the speech is Sextags and the City, or Localizing a Long-Term Game Project, Megapolis. Here I am. I hold the position of a localization manager at All Correct Group company. And this photo is not the most up-to-date. I think like this one is better. It's just worth an accident. This is the logo of our company. Our company was founded in 2006, and we have experience in localizing for almost 6 years already. We focus on European and Asian languages, but we actually can translate into 40 plus languages. Frankly speaking, any. We have proven record with many big clients. There are far more than 100 of them, and we have localized more than 350 game titles. Most of them should be recognizable for you, but I would like to talk to you about my personally loved one, the most exciting one, which is called Megapolis. And to begin with, I would like you to see some video about it. Okay. That's it. It frankly didn't start from the very beginning, but I think you might quote some localized phrases out of it. So let's talk about the content. First, I will say some general words about the game, about the developer of the game and the project features. Then I'll go to the main three services that we provided to the customer: localization of the game texts, localizing testing, and game community support. And to sum it all up, I will share up some best practices that we figured out of that project. So talking about the developer, it's called Social Quantum. In 2014, according to the Pocket Gamer Top 50, they were at the place number 32, and as mentioned here, their key game is Megapolis. Megapolis is a city building game, and it is presented on some online platforms and mobile platforms, and it is number one economic strategy game in more than 20 countries. It has about 10 million people of its audience and 1 million hits a day. It is presented on two social networks, VK, a rather popular Russian one, and Facebook, well known. It is a cross-platform game. It is on iOS, on Windows Phone, and on Android. Megapolis is full of different buildings which have equivalents in the real world, ranging from the ancient times to some real up-to-date ones. And in 2012, Social Quantum decided to promote his game in 20 countries, and the contractor that they chose was all correct. And the main development language is Russian. After that, the game is translated into 10 other languages, which are in the list here. But there is one extra one, which I will tell you about a little bit later during the speech. The game, the project started in November 2012 and ended up in March of 2015. It was about 4 million people so far, more 4 million words so far that we translated during this project. And the team consisted of 39 members, translators, editors, and one project manager. Let's talk about the first service that we provided during this project. It was localizing of the game text and its two main lines, localizing of the main text and localizing of game updates. Talking about the localizing of the main text, here is the workflow of it. Firstly, as the development language was Russian, we translated from Russian into English. Then came a very crucial step. An employee from the Social Quantum helped a lot. He checked all text localized from Russian into English and suggested some corrections for not, you know, issues go into other languages when we translate from English into other languages. So that was a real good part for it. There were two main lines inside it. When Social Quantum came to us, they had already had some texts from the other vendor, which were in English, Spanish, French, and Portuguese, Brazil. And there were other languages that we started from scratch. You can see the flags for them. And the first thing we did here was the quality assurance of those texts that came with the Social Quantum, and it showed out that the quality was low. There were repeating semantic and grammatical errors and formal style. Talking about formal style in games, in video games, in formal style is highly recommended to be used. And though English is not so sensitive about it, what is this? Okay, like this. The English is not so sensitive, and it doesn't have differentiations as it has you or your for both formal and informal style. Though the other languages like Russian, German, or French, here you have definitely use the informal style and has some definite pronouns for it. And this is the example of a grammar mistake that we found in a mobile version. For example, here we have to put the preposition to and through in the button, but actually we ended up on a decision for the button as log in Facebook, as it is more short, which is more efficient for the buttons and more elegant for it. And remember I told you about one extra language, that was Arabic. The interesting thing about it is that it has right to the left form, but that was not a problem for us from the point of localizing. That was just the thing is that Facebook is closed in most of the Arabian countries. That's why we localized it for 1 year, but eventually it wasn't launched. The game wasn't launched in Arabian language. Okay. Of course, there were a lot of, you know, like things that to solve which, a lot of challenges, to solve which we had to use most of our creativity. Such of them was the Sextag. Here it is. It adapts the text according to the gender's user, to the user's gender. For example, here how it is works for the female user. We see that the system detects that she is female and puts her. On the other hand, if the user is male, it puts him. Why it is so important? Okay. This tag can be used with any kind of text. Here we can see that it is used for the achievement name, and you might notice that for Korean it's not used. That frankly concerns three languages, Japanese, Chinese simplified, and Korean, because these three languages do not have genders, but they have strict you know, variants for some words for female and male versions. So that's why it was rapidly used, really. Why it is, this tag was so important? Because it makes the text to talk to the user more personally. And it was mostly used in timeline posting. So and what is a timeline posting? Timeline posting invites persons to come and buy stuff. And here you can see the picture of a pleased developer. And what we have, a pleased developer in the end and a pleased player, of course. And since we've talked about languages, we asked the social quantum to provide a rating of the languages according to the profit that they gave them. So on the first place is English, I think it's obvious. Second is German and Japanese, and the other goes just a little bit less profit. So then we localized the updates. The usual update was a page in a newspaper for the user, description of it, then some quests in the game, then some achievement names, some sales and discounts and material names, and of course new buildings. Usually it came twice a week to us. Each update was approximately 2,000 words. If it was less than 500 words, we did it the same day. If it was more, then later. And we translated the game updates usually one or two months before it was really implemented into the game. And we had two tools for maintaining the quality, the so-called CAT tool, Computer Assistant Translating System, which is called MemoQ, and the style guide, which we filled in with the customer before we really started on their project. And the most crucial things here is the source and the target language, any reference materials, links to the game, etc., platforms which will be used, treatment of the game title, translate or not, string limits, then mode address to the player, formal, informal, and that's it. The second one service that we provided was the testing, yes, localization testing. Testers played just the place, just the place where the text of an update were implemented, and reported the bugs. Two kinds of the localizational bugs. Here, for example, the tester suggests to modify the name of the building and to add the word complex, and the functional one bugs. Here we see that the ribbon covers the name of the building, and the test suggests to reduce the size of the ribbon, but actually Social Quantum just moved a little bit to the right the titles, the names of the buildings. And here we see that there is an empty space for the text is not shown properly, or the ID instead of the name. So these all things that the customer fixed on themselves. A bonus for them was that the functional bugs were caught for free by us. And the second is that actually after 2 years they stopped this service. But the scene was that it's been a long time since this stage revealed any errors. It just says that we were so super good on the stage of translating. That's why they just didn't need testing at all. And the game community support, it consisted of two main services. The first was support for the users in their local languages. When they asked questions, for example, Portuguese, Brazil, we translated into English for the customer, customer answered, and then we translated again into the original language of the question. And this is another thing. Social Quantum performed a forum where the user could make a post about the suspected place in the game where he thinks or she thinks that there is an error. We validated all these things with the experts, with the native experts, if it turned out to be valid. The user got 5 units of in-game currency, which is called Megabucks, and of course we fixed it for free. Talking about the statistics, when we started this service, there were about 40 valid and 60 non-valid, and about 100 posts per month. But the scene really became better in 1 year. It was just 10 posts per month. The thing is that, firstly, there were a lot of, you know, those texts of core texts of low quality, and most of those posts were concerning these texts. And after we corrected them, fixed them, you see that it's only 10 posts per month. Two bonuses for the customer again. They made up an FAQ, a multilingual one, out of questions and answers. And again, they stopped the support community. And that's just because the number of the posts were 10, and it was not so crucial for them, comparing especially with the beginning when it was a lot of. We asked the customer to provide the feedback on our work, and they said that they proved the idea that it was a great part by all correct in their success, in the success of Megapolis. And to sum up, I would like to tell you about the best practices. There are just a few of them. First of all, again, make quality assurance of the text you have. Don't save your money on testing, especially it is rather crucial on the start of the project and can be stopped after a while. Then make a community support for the users. They are really pleased about it. And you can make an FAQ out of it, and again, you can stop it after a while, just it. And give a person, an employee from your site, from the developer side or from the publisher side who is in the game to consult the translators. Use the task tracking system, any Redmond, Jira, Oracle, or any, just to make the work more efficient. And of course, give this work to the professional localizers. They would do it the best, yeah. So, and the last thing I would like to tell you is we just try to look if they're building in the game which has an equivalent and each is situated in Israel. And it turned out that there is one. This is the, from my personal opinion, kind of a square architecture. So you can still have a visit to it. So that's it. Thank you for attending this speech. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm ready to answer any questions if you have any.
So I'm really interested actually on the whole kind of live updates and support part, because obviously the big change that's happened in games is the fact that they're no longer just a product you build, you know, you go through localization, you release, and that's it. Suddenly we've now got this process where we've got live support, we've got to support our customers and so on. How, you know, you mentioned a bit about the kind of pricing of that, but how, and the time scales, which seemed quite long, that it was about a 2 month time scale. Have you got any experience of working much faster? I mean, there's companies talking about, you know, updates every week or every 2 weeks, and how does that work with localization? Because obviously I could see that becoming quite a, you know, both costly and a lot of work for you guys as well.
So you mean that can we work faster?
No, I suppose, have you got experience of games that update a lot quicker? So doing an update, yes, every week and actually going through that. And also, so
yes,
what experience do you have with that?
Yes, especially concerning Megapolis. It was an ideal situation when we translated the text 2 or 1 month before they were implemented in the game. Of course, there were some batches that for example, tomorrow they have an update and they have forgotten to give them to us, or just at the end, just before the release of a new update, they decide to implement a few more buildings, a few more discounts, and they ask us to do it rapidly. Sometimes you have to stay at work a little bit more just to...
So do you become much more kind of embedded into the company because of the fact that you're having to work so closely if it's a quick update?
Yes. Okay. Yes, of course, of course.
Any other questions?
Hi. My question is about translating to like such specific languages like Korean, like Japanese, and so on. So, for example, if you translate to English or Spanish, you probably you can find like more or less good translator in house, for example, like in Russia, and yes. He can read the text, and for example, he cannot be sure that it's perfect, but it can be sure that it's more or less fine, so that you will then release it and you have some feedback about some bugs, but it will not be like critical. But what about like Korean languages? Is it possible to find some editor that can that you can trust him and do not have such situations that you like got some translation, you released it, and then you have like a lot of bad feedback, like what the hell, it's like completely fail. So how to manage such situation?
The thing is that one more tool that we kept to maintain the quality on especially Megapolis was the cross quality assurance. What I mean is that, for example, we have an amount of words translated during 1 month. We collect them and give it to another expert. And your question is how we can trust this expert. Usually these are the people whom we, first of all, work for a long time, since our country, our company is working since 2009. Almost 6 years, so they have proved really relationship with us, proved their quality. But on the first steps, we had a very strong testing testing system for the translator, for the editor to become a part of our team. So also, we during this time we have maintained such a relationship with all our translators, because we work day to day closely to each other, always online, and speaking video conversations. We see them. When you talk to a person, you can just understand rapidly if he is in, you know, the business or out. So that's it. Yes, we had some people, and also we make if we have a member of team who has made the translation and he is our expert, we also give we also perform quality assurances of his works too, once per month, because you know when a person works he is good, always good, but something can happen for him. And just, you know, like we are all humans, or he was ill or something like that, and he did the text with a lower quality and made some maybe grammatical errors or something like that. And our translators checks the works of each other. So that's it.
One of the things with working with translators, especially over long periods of time, is that I assume you've got some switchover of translators for whatever reason. How do you keep consistency between texts? I mean, it can be grammatically correct, even if it doesn't sound the same.
Consistency is our main focus, I can say. How we keep it, we use MemoQ. MemoQ is a computer assistant translation system. It has the support of translation memory, first of all, and the glossary. So if you imagine a desktop of a translator who is translated inside a professional CAD tool, he has the source, the target columns for translating, and on the right he has the advices, the tips that the system gives him out of the translation memory. For example, if one scene was at the beginning of the 2000 words text, it was called a very strict way, be sure that the system would pick up the this translation from the translation memory and advise the translator to use the same variant of translation. That's it.
What is it called one more time, the tool?
MemoQ? MemoQ, yes. There are quite a few of them, but we have tried few, but from my personal experience, it's not an advertising at all, but I really prefer MemoQ. It's fantastic. And it's, it has put the industry on a new level. I mean, the development of these translation memory systems of these CAD tools has put the industry on a new level, especially for the consistency.
What about localization in Hebrew? Any experience in that?
Yes, we have an experience, and surprisingly, recently more and more customers would like to translate into Hebrew, but most of them are now a kind of touching the industry because they start with some marketing texts, not translating the game in whole into Hebrew, just some marketing to pick up the users out of this country and maybe searching if they are interested. But of course we've got already a few titles of the games, not so big really actually, but they were localized into Hebrew. And Hebrew also is fully supported by MemoQ, by translation systems. So actually there is no a language that has that we cannot work with. That's it.
Anything else? Okay, well thank you very much, Dmitry.
Thank you very much. Thanks for attending.